Hey guys, this is Chris the Fit French. Getting six packs, abs, or a flat stomach is probably the most searched subject on the internet regarding fitness right now. I don't think it's that complicated, but there are a lot of confusing information, and it looks so hard when you read all these articles that I wanted to make a video about this, and we're gonna start right now. So getting a six-pack ab, of course, it might look difficult or complicated because when you read these articles, they tell you to do a lot of reps every day, like up to like 200, 400, or maybe 1,000 abs exercises per day. And this is crazy. It's insane because if your diet is not in check, well, it's not going to be efficient. So to get six-pack abs, there are two factors that are going to be very important. It's your diet and the exercises that you're going to do, the hypertrophy that you're going to provoke to your abs, because abs are also muscles, but they have to be worked in a certain way. So in terms of getting your diet right, you have to lower your body fat, and this, you probably know that, but you have to find the solution, the best solution for you to reduce body fat, and in a very efficient way. I mean, don't try to lose like 10 kilos in 1 week. This is not going to work and it's not healthy. You're going to have to lose probably between 500 grams and 1 kilo per week so that you don't lose muscle mass. And this is like a general advice. In terms of exercises, then what I usually do is a mix of strength exercises. So like, if I would like to get bigger abs, then bigger muscle in my abs, then I will provoke hypertrophy. And this is what you want to do. You want to do cable rope crunches, for instance, or do some exercises with added weights so that you put more pressure on your abs and they grow bigger. You create hypertrophy. You can also do more like planks and crunches without weights. So a combination of the two will be very efficient to build your abs. And you wanna target your upper abs, your lower abs, and your obliques. And I will show you all these exercises that I do in my next video. But of course, I don't do those exercises in one training session. I try to do it 3 or 4 times a week, different exercises, and I try to hit different part of the abs. To go back to the diet, because I think it's the main reason that you're gonna have some six-pack abs in the end, you're gonna have to lower something in your diet to make it better so that you're gonna lose fat. So what I personally do is I try to reduce my fat intake as much as possible by not using cooking oil. I mean, I use palm oil, for instance. My carbs, I try to lower them. I try to reduce my carb intake as much as possible, but I try to also strategically eat them, you know, when I really, really feel like eating carbs, you know. It's not like I'm gonna say or tell myself I'm gonna eat carbs at each meal a certain amount. No, what I'm gonna do is save the carbs for the evening when I'm really hungry, and the rest of the day I'm gonna eat as much veggies, green veggies as possible, so that, you know, I can actually burn the fat as much as possible. And you wanna consider drinking a lot of water, because it's gonna cut the hunger as much as possible. You can also think about intermittent fasting. It's very efficient. The goal here is to eat as far as possible, as late as possible, so that you can save some calories for later. So those are very efficient techniques to lose fat. If it's not working for you, if you feel too hungry, definitely add in some cardio, for instance, because some people are more comfortable with, you know, reducing their diet, and so are more comfortable with doing more cardio. I personally prefer focusing on my diet, and the only cardio that I do is walking very fast as possible for 20 minutes, and I try to do that 2 or 3 times a week. And also, I walk as much as possible during my lunch breaks, or when I get out of the office, I try to walk more than usually. So that's what I do to lose fat, and that's how I can see my abs. Last thing you wanna consider to reduce fat or to reduce your weight and reveal your abs is actually, because you're gonna drink a lot of water, is to reduce your salt intake. Salt is everywhere, especially if you eat processed food. It's gonna be used anywhere, so you have to be careful of your salt intake. I personally Never add salt in anything, in any of my food. I add spices. I find it much better, much enjoyable. And this will help because salt is going to retain water, so it's going to make you look bigger, a bit of more water in your body, so you're not going to see your abs. And if you see like those shows or those models, what they do is that they don't drink water 6 hours before the photo shoot, and that's how you know they look so shredded. So I don't ask you to do that, I don't advise you to do that, but if you really want to make progress in your weight cut and you want to see your abs, then it might be a good solution to reduce your salt intake. Also, it's good for you. But on the contrary, if you're feeling bad or if you're losing too much water, then stick to the salt intake and just reduce your fat or your carbs, for instance. So now let me take you to my exercise routine for abs. Usually I do it at the end of my workout, and I don't try to have a specific day for abs because I think it's a good break after you did the upper body or lower body. Of course, when you're gonna work out your legs, for example, the leg press or the squat, you're gonna work your abs as well. You know, the core is used in most of our exercises, so you don't have to do a lot of abs exercises if you're already weightlifting. So that's why I try to do a few exercises here and then and focus on my diet. So let me show you my exercises.
The wake up. Listen here, fuck boy. I'm the new guy on a block now. Save you from the school of hard knocks, boy, you dropped out. I don't see the credentials, I don't see the potential. Every night I'm in my room with a pad and a pencil. Said no to the fuck shit. These days, who knows what trust is? I'm just trying to make moves and get up quick. And you know that we are nothing to be fucked with. Man, I just want a million, I just want a billion. I just want to be in a room full of Brazilians. I just want to travel overseas, going crazy over me. Getting high, eating pizza with Sicilians. And I don't care what you say, I'ma be on top like the toupee. I'ma skirt in a coupe. Oops, I'm in the coupe though. Fuck you motherfuckers in a loophole. I'll get my money fast, homie, you slow. And I take fatties and you take little ones. And you talking shit, what's a tank to a little gun? I got nothing but time, got nothing but rhymes. And mine's coming soon like I'm fucking the time. Now my SoundCloud's lit. I've been on my SoundProud shit. I've been on my bow down shit. Cause I feel like the king of my type. And nobody's like me and that's alright. Feeling so good and gracious. Been so patient. I always try to stray away from fake shit. The money won't come to those who waiting. Gotta get an album before the shitty races, getting faded in different places, meeting people, seeing different faces, way too gone to remember the names.
When I'm done my exercise, I try to have as much water as possible to hydrate, and I try to eat later, so I'm gonna have, for instance, some coffee, so I have energy and I don't feel hungry. So those are my tips when I'm cutting usually. And I try to focus also on having whole wheat bread or very nutrient rich food like spinach, for instance, because it contains protein and you feel full after eating them. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please make sure to like and comment down below. Subscribe to the channel for more, and until then, peace out.